Hey everyone, it's Lauren. I'm coming to you today with a weekly weight loss recipe. I decided to switch it from Wednesdays because that just wasn't working for me, and I definitely want to get these out to you. Today we're doing something cool, a lasagna in a bowl. This is no noodles, high protein, low carb. So two components for a great lasagna is a great meat sauce and a great cheese sauce, and I'm going to show you how to do both of those with my own recipes here today, and you'll be able to put it together on a piece-by-piece basis to be perfect for weight loss surgery size portions. For our meat sauce, we're going to need a 24-ounce jar of your favorite spaghetti sauce, some butter, a half a large onion, 3 cloves of garlic, 1/4 tablespoon of white sugar, 16 ounces of turkey breakfast sausage or any type of sausage or meat you want to use. I've got basil, oregano, parsley. I also use some herbs de Provence. You can also use Italian seasoning. I've got garlic powder and my salt and pepper to taste, as always. So we're going to start by getting our vegetables ready, chopping up this onion. We're going to dice this finely. And I realized here it was hard to cut this way, so I flipped my onion. I speed it up a little bit here. You're just going to finely dice your onion. If you don't know how to dice an onion, there's plenty of helpful YouTube videos on how to do that. And then after our onion, we're going to start cutting up our garlic. Now, I'm just going to smack each clove of garlic with my knife over it like this, and that helps you peel the skin right off. Great tip. My garlic was a little bit old, so garlic starts to grow, and there's these stem parts in the middle, so all you have to do is cut it in half and pick that out. Don't throw your garlic away, guys. It's totally good for a good amount of time. And so that's what I'm doing here. I'm just picking out the stem parts. And I'm just roughly chopping this because I am putting it in a crusher later on. Now, if you don't have a garlic crusher or mincer, whatever you like to call it, please do mince this finely with your knife. I'm going to save that part for later. Once we have our onions and our garlic all prepped, we are going to start on the stove. So what you're going to need is a large stainless steel pan or a nonstick skillet, whatever you like, enough to hold a good amount of sauce. You're going to put this over medium-high heat. And you're going to throw in your tablespoon of butter. Sorry, I forgot to show you earlier, you might need some olive oil. I'm using only half a tablespoon. The cool thing about cooking with butter and olive oil is you get the taste of the butter, but the olive oil is able to sustain those high temperatures of cooking, and your butter won't burn. You're going to throw in your diced onion, seasoned with just a little bit of salt and pepper, and mix that all together. I like to cook the onion before the meat because I really like a nice tender brown onion. That's why I start before the meat. This is only going to take 5 minutes. I have this on medium-high heat again. So 5 minutes on medium-high, I'll show you what that looks like just in a second. Now, my boyfriend was the cameraman, did not let me know if we were not zoomed in anymore. So sorry about the different angle change. But so you can see my onions just started to brown around the edges. I'm going to turn the heat down to medium because we're putting the garlic in. Here's my garlic crusher. I got it at IKEA for like $2. I suggest picking one up. It's totally easy. Throw your cloves in there, and we're only going to heat this for about a minute, guys. You don't want the garlic to brown. You just want to get it all fragrant and delicious. I like a lot of garlic. You don't have to use as many cloves. If you're not a garlic fan, please cut down on it. We're going to throw our turkey breakfast sausage in. I love the taste of breakfast sausage. You can use Italian sausage, you can use ground beef, whatever, the meat of your choices. I've done it with a lot of different meats. Today I just found this in the grocery store and thought, oh, that would be good. So we're going to break this up and we're going to start browning it over medium or medium high. I think I left it on medium high, turned it back up. So this took me 10 minutes on medium high heat, and you see, this is why I like cooking with stainless steel. You get the delicious brown bits on the bottom of the pan. That's going to add so much flavor. You can deglaze with wine here. I'm just going to use the sauce and the water. So I'm throwing in my entire jar, 24 ounces of Francesco Rinaldi. This is my favorite tomato sauce. Again, please use your favorite or use crushed tomatoes, make your own sauce. I'm adding enough seasonings, which that could work too. A great tip, I put about 1/4 cup of water in that jar and I shook it around, and there you go. You use all the sauce up, don't waste any bit. So you're gonna scrape the bottom of the pan with your wooden spoon. I'm doing that here. Get all of those delicious caked on bits into your sauce. You definitely want that's free flavor. Please utilize it. So we're gonna season here. I'm throwing in about 1/4 tablespoon of white sugar. You don't have to add that. I do like my sauce sweet. My parents always made it like this. It's kind of comforting to me. And it doesn't add too much to the final recipe because this sauce is like 8 servings, guys. So I'm adding parsley, basil, oregano, herbs de Provence, all those. I'm going to put measurements down below in the description box, but please add what you like what taste you like. I don't even measure it. You can see I'm just kind of throwing it in. So I'm going to give you measurements what I think would what I would be using, but please do that to your taste and then taste it. You see me, oh, it was good. I tasted it twice. So taste it, add seasoning, and I decided it needed some more salt and pepper, a lot more pepper. I need a new pepper grinder. Mine is definitely biting the dust here, so I definitely had to work to get that. I added a little bit of garlic powder. Again, I love garlic, but that is, again, optional. So we're gonna mix that, and then you're gonna turn it down to medium or medium low, and just when you have bubbles in it. You're gonna let that simmer until everything else is ready. That's it, guys, that's your meat sauce. So for our wonderful cheese mixture, you're going to need 2 ounces of part skim ricotta, part skim mozzarella, and Parmigiano Reggiano cheese. You're gonna use an egg and oregano, salt and pepper. You can get the Parmesan Reggiano and Parmesan in the can, but the fresh is so much better. Grate your own. You see, I grated it already because it does take a little bit of time. How I like to measure this out is I put my bowl on my kitchen scale so I know exactly how much I'm getting. For this cheese sauce, and this fed me and my boyfriend, so this is more than one serving, but I'm putting 2 ounces of ricotta cheese, 1 egg. Again, the egg is just for extra protein. I like the extra protein that the egg adds, and I do like the flavor. If you're not a fan, or you've never made lasagna with an egg in your cheese mixture, don't add it. It's totally fine. I just enjoy the extra protein and the taste. I add oregano, salt, and pepper. Oregano gives it a kind of pizza taste to me, which I really enjoy in my Italian food. So we're going to do that. That's it for the cheese sauce. It's really easy. Yeah, it does look a little weird. That's because of the egg, but I do like it that way, and I can take all the extra protein I can. So at this point, preheat your oven to 375 degrees Fahrenheit. You're going to start building your sauce. So in a little heat-proof bowl, I've got this cute bunny dish I got at the grocery store. You're going to put, again, I put this on top of my scale so I know exactly how much I'm measuring out. First down goes 1.5 ounces of the meat sauce. I try to focus on the chunks so I get a lot of protein. And then on top of that is 1/2 ounce of your ricotta mixture. On top of that is going to be 0.25 or 1/4 ounce of the shredded mozzarella. And we're building this just like a lasagna. And then on top of that, I'm going to add another 1.5 ounces of the tomato sauce. I used a little more of the sauce to get it nice and creamy. And finally, on top, to get that classic bubbly cheesy texture, we're gonna add 1/4 ounce of the mozzarella. Stick that in your 375 degree oven for about, mine only took 10 minutes. And oh my God, guys, here it is. It's bubbling, it's hot, it looks amazing. It looks just like lasagna without the noodles. For comparison, here's my boyfriend's serving. You can definitely see. So the measurements I gave you here are going to make a 4 ounce serving. I wanna try this, it's really hot. Let me grab a fork and let you know how it is. So can you just see that? Can we take a moment to appreciate that cheese? Who doesn't love cheese? It was really hot, I couldn't eat the whole bite, but it was so delicious. That spaghetti sauce is comforting, it tastes just like home. I just wanted to show you real quick at the end, I couldn't finish the whole 4 ounce portion at about 30-45 minutes, so I did let it sit about 30-45 minutes and then eat the rest so I could get all the stats from it. I give it a thumbs up, my boyfriend gave it a thumbs up. This tasted just like a lasagna without the noodles. So thank you so much for watching, I hope you give this a try. All the recipe information is down below in the description box. You'll find nutrition information and ingredients. I hope you enjoyed watching, and I'll see you guys later this week. Bye.